So let's get it started. This next guy. Now, there's a lot of guys in the world. You got your ugly guys, your fat guys, your skinny guys, your tall guys. There's only one Geechy guy. How about a hand for Geechy Guy?
Boy, is it tall, thin, and goofy in here? Or is it just me? I can step here forever. I got so much stuff, it's not even funny.
It is comedy time. Our returning champion made his first appearance as a juggler at the age of 6. 20 years later, he's got a whole new act. He'd better. He's going for win number 3. Here's Geechy Guy. And Hollywood's hottest new comic is Geechy Guy.
Officials from the Guinness Book of World Records were in the improv audience for one particular comic. Geechy Guy set a new world's record for most jokes told in 1 hour, 676.
My old school R&B station has been sending me mixed signals. I don't know if I'm supposed to get down on it or get up off of that thing. Get down on it, okay. Get up off of that thing! Sorry. Get down on it! Okay. Get up off of that thing!
Comedy champion, Geechy Guy!
The next gentleman was recently voted Hollywood's hottest new comic. He's been seen right here on Comic Strip Live, a forum for just such people. And he's also been seen on Star Search. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Geechy Guy.
Have with us a gentleman who was in town last night as the opening act for the Righteous Brothers, performed at the Grand Ole Opry House. He's been seen on virtually every national comedy show. He has played just all the clubs and arenas from coast to coast. Very popular comedic act.
Please welcome Geechy Guy. Yes.
He can be seen opening for Rita Rudner at the Sands Hotel in Las Vegas, February 29th through March 13th, and at the Riviera Comedy Club in Las Vegas, March 18th through the 24th. Please welcome Geechy Guy.
People think I'm Geechy Guy. Yeah, which is a compliment.
I like traveling, staying in hotels. One time I was in a hotel room and I got so interested in reading the Bible that I stole it. Well, I feel really bad now because I just got to that page. You'd think they'd put the stealing part closer to the front, you know. At least in the hotel version, you'd think they'd switch with Noah or something. You know, or have a see page 93 quick sticker, you know, on the, nothing.
Geechy Guy, I did comics only. What was it called?
The
A list. Only the top 5,000 comics got on
there. Right.
A subpoena for me?
Ooh, thank you. It sounds very exciting. May I come just as I am?
No, you must come as Geechy Guy.
Hey!
I saw a show the other day about Patrick Henry. You know who that is? He said, give me liberty or give me death. That's pretty cool, huh? I wouldn't have said that. I mean, that's pretty drastic. I would have left some middle ground there, you know? Really. I mean, I would have said, like, give me liberty or forget I said anything. You know, or give me liberty or I'll just shut up and mind my own business. You know, or give me liberty if that's cool, and if not, that's okay, too. You know? Okay, if you got some extra liberty laying around, I'll take it. You know, I'll even come pick it up. You don't have to deliver it or nothing. I'm just saying, if there's a surplus of liberty around your parts, that's kind of what I'm in the market for. So it would probably be to both of our advantages if we got together and talked about it. See, that's what I would say. Maybe, you know, I certainly wouldn't say give me liberty or shoot me in the head. You know, what kind of thinking is that?
There's a Sam Tripoli bit that reminds me of Geechy Guy. It says, if you want time to yourself, tell your friends that you're going to be moving. and then you won't hear from anyone for at least 2 weeks. Geechy was quite the opposite. Geechy not only helped me move, he offered to help me move, and then he smoked me out after. Geechy Guy was actually a judge at the Cannabis Cup in Amsterdam, and I believe it was the second strain that he smoked, and he said, this is the best weed I've ever had. I don't need to smoke any other weed to know that. That was actually the best strain, and it won the Cannabis Cup that year. I mean, that is how discerning he was as a pot connoisseur. I guess we could call him the Napoleon Dynamite of weed. I know I'm not the only comedian that admired him for his joke writing skills, but he was really a tremendous human being. I love you, Geech, and we miss you.
So sometime back in the 1980s, I met a comedian with the unlikely name of Geechy Guy, and I always thought from the very beginning he was one of the funniest guys I'd ever seen, and I've worked with a lot of them. Later on, we got to work together here in Las Vegas, and it was always a highlight when I came to the Mirage to be able to watch Geechy up there doing his thing. And he was a great guy too. I loved hanging out with him after the show. Geechy, you will be missed.
Look at me. I'm limited. And just look at you. You can do all I couldn't do, Linda. So now it's up to you. For both of us. Now it's up to people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood, who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, I have been changed for good. It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime, so let me say before we part, so much of me is made of what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart, and now whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a sea dropped by a sky bird in a distant world, who can say if I've been changed for the better? But I know you, because I knew you, I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for. But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore. Like a comet goes far, it as it passes a by a wind off the sea. Like a stream that meets a boulder, halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? I do believe I have been changed for the better. And because I knew you, because I knew you, because I knew you,
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for coming. It would have meant the world to Geechy that you're all here. In 2010, Geechy Guy created a show called The Dirty Joke Show, a play about three comedians hanging out after their show inside a comedy club telling dirty jokes to one another. It ran for over 2 years at Hooters Casino. This is a tribute to that show. If you're offended by foul language, barnyard buggery, general ass fucking.
I meant to say cock.
Cocks. Just leave now. Otherwise, sit down, relax, ask your drunk girlfriend to shut the fuck up. And enjoy this version of the Dirty Joke Show.
This feels like the Dirty Joke Show, you know?
Yeah, kind of, yeah.
It's weird. He was the... I never knew how to tell a joke, like a street joke, before I met him. And it was the one, you know the one.
Which one?
Old man, old woman going to bed. The old man's already in bed. The old woman comes out of the bathroom. She's completely naked. She jumps up on the bed and goes, "Super pussy!" And the old man looks and goes, "I'll take the soup." That was the one I learned how to tell
that's
a joke.
That's a really good one. Yeah, yeah. I know one on a whole different subject. I remember the first one I think I ever learned how to do. So this guy walks into a bar, and this guy is shit-faced, and he says, "Bartender, I want a drink." And the bartender says, "Sir, you are drunk. I cannot serve you. Please leave." Guy leaves. 2 minutes later, same drunk walks in that side of the same bar. He goes, "Bartender, I want a drink." The bartender says, "Sir, I already told you you're drunk. Get out of here." He leaves again. 3 minutes later, same drunk walks in that side of the same bar. "Bartender, for God's sake, I need a drink." And the bartender says, "For the last time, you are drunk. I cannot serve you." And the drunk says, "How many fucking bars do you work at?" That was a good one, right?
Yeah, it was a good one.
Just checking.
No, that was good. I like the one Geechy told me about why the pervert crossed the road, because his dick was still stuck in the chicken.
Sure, because...
He loved those weird animal jokes.
That was a good one.
My favorite weird animal one he ever told me was the one about the little penguin. Do you know this one? A penguin driving down the street, right? As they do in their cars.
As they do.
And he's eating like an ice cream cone, you know, and he hits this bump in the street and he breaks down. He calls for the repair guy and he comes along, the hood's open, and a little penguin wanders on round. He goes, "Well, what's wrong?" And the repair guy goes, "Well, it looks like you blew a seal." And the guy, he goes, "No, I've just been eating an ice cream cone. I would never."
My favorite animal joke was a guy goes out bear hunting and he sees a bear, he shoots at him, but he misses. Bear gets all pissed off, tracks the guy down, pulls his pants down, fucks him in the ass, and runs off. The hunter's just he can't believe this has happened to him. Next day, he goes, "I'm going to get that bear." So he goes out the next day, he's looking, sees the bear, shoots at him again, misses a second time. Bear chases after him, does it again, pulls down his pants, fucks him in the ass, and then runs off into the wood. Well, now the hunter's he's out of his mind. He goes, "Tomorrow, I'm getting that fucking bear." So he goes out there, sees the bear again, shoots at him, misses a third time. Bear chases him down, grabs him by the lapels. He goes, "You're not out here for the hunting, are you?"
I'm trying to remember all those ones. Guy comes home to find his wife with the bags packed. He goes, "Where are you going?" She goes, "I'm going to Las Vegas. I just read that in Las Vegas you can get $400 for a blowjob. $400 for what I'm giving you for free. I'm moving to Las Vegas." Guy runs upstairs, comes back down. His bags are packed. She goes, "Where are you going?" "Going with you. Going to watch you live on $800 a year."
Yes. Those are the good ones. I don't care what you say.
How about the joke about the young married...
You okay, Matt? You all right? Everything okay?
What are you doing over there?
Hey.
Oh, well, I ran out of weed, and Geech fucking probably was made at least 30% THC. Ah, okay. So... Yeah. Geech all over me. What the fuck?
Well, that's how you got in the show, wasn't it?
I know. My favorite Cheerios joke was where'd that fucking come from? Jesus Christ. Two kids sitting at the breakfast table, and the mother comes down and says to the first kid, "What do you want for breakfast?" First kid says, "I want some fucking Cheerios." The mother said, "What did you say?" "Mom, I want some fucking Cheerios. I'm hungry." The mother says, "I'm sure I heard that wrong. One more time. Let me hear that." Kid says, "Mom, I want some fucking Cheerios." Mother says, "That's it." She takes the kid, smacks him, throws him in his room, locks the door, says, "You stay there till tomorrow." Then she says to the second kid, "What do you want for breakfast?" And the second kid says, "I'll tell you one thing. I don't want any fucking Cheerios."
I love those little kid ones. Okay, so a guy, a salesman, knocks on a door one day, and the door opens, and there's this little 8-year-old kid, and he's completely naked, and he's holding a bottle of scotch in one hand and a joint in the other. And the salesman goes, "Are your parents home?" And the kid looks up and goes, "Does it fucking look like my parents are home?" What the fuck?
How about the young married couple? They're struggling for money. They don't know what they're going to do, so the husband finally tells the wife, he says, "Listen, you're just going to have to prostitute yourself so we can get some money. I don't know what else to tell you." So she goes, "Fine, I'll go out and I'll do what I got to do." So the next morning, the husband wakes up and the wife's down at the table and she's counting out money. He goes, "How much did you make?" And she goes, "I made $505. He goes, "Holy shit." He goes, "Who the fuck gave you $5? And she goes, "Everybody."
It's been a busy night, baby. Real busy fucking night.
There was a shower involved afterwards.
Mother and her adorable 7-year-old kid, you know this one? So they're driving in the car, you know, and they're behind this huge dump truck. And the mother's having a cute little conversation with her 7-year-old. He's so adorable. And while they're talking, out off the top of the dump truck, this huge dildo comes flying off the top and smacks into the windshield. And the mother looks at the kid, and the kid looks at the mother, and she thinks fast. She goes, "Boy, Johnny, that was a really large insect, wasn't it?" And Johnny goes, "Yeah, Mom, it's amazing you could fly with a dick that big."
All right, a little 7-year-old kid goes up to his dad, and he goes, "Hey, where do babies come from?" And the dad goes, "Well, the stork." And the little kid looks up at his dad and goes, "You fucked a stork?" Gross.
It makes a lot of sense, that question, you know?
How about this? An Uber driver picks up a nun. He's checking her out in the rearview mirror. He's looking at her. He can't take his eyes off her. She notices it. She goes, "I'm sorry, is there a problem?" He goes, "Nah, I'm sorry, sister. It's just that I've always had this fantasy about having sex with a nun." She goes, "Really? Are you a Catholic?" He goes, "Yes, I am." She goes, "Pull over." He pulls over. She jumps in the front seat, gives him the best blowjob he's ever had in his life. He's laying back. He's feeling guilty. He goes, "You know, sister, I got to be honest with you. I'm not really Catholic." She goes, "That's okay. My name is Frank. I'm on the way to a Halloween party."
So there's a faith healer in town, and he's you know those guys that they heal people? So the guy's got the tent all set up, and he's on stage, and he's preaching to the crowd, and he goes, "We're going to heal people tonight under this tent. Who wants to be healed?" Little gentleman comes to the end of the stage on crutches, and he goes, "What's your name?" He goes, "My name is Dennis." He goes, "Well, Dennis, come up on stage. Go behind the curtain, because we're going to heal you tonight." Next gentleman comes up to the stage to be healed. He goes, "And what's your name?" He goes, "My name is Michael." "Oh, Michael, what ails you?" "I have a speech impediment." He goes, "You go behind the curtain with Dennis, because you too tonight are going to be healed." And then the preacher's like, "Okay, everyone, hold hands. We're going to heal these gentlemen tonight. Now we're going to pray, and Dennis, throw those crutches over the curtain." And the crutches come flying over the curtain, and they crash on the stage. And he goes, "Now, Michael, say something." And Michael goes, "Dennis fell down."
Husband and wife driving along the street, and they get stopped by a cop, and the cop says to the husband, "Give me your license." And the husband gives the license, and the cop says, "Oh, you're from Chicago? I fucking hate Chicago. I fucking hate Chicago. Worst blowjob I ever got was in Chicago." And the wife says to the husband, "What's he saying?" And the husband goes, "He says he knows you."
All right, before we leave... Geechy was the best at telling jokes.
He really was.
If there was a guy that knew a joke, he knew it. And you couldn't throw him. You just couldn't. Anything you'd say, he'd have a joke for it. And here's an example. We asked Geechy one night, "Geechy, tell us 10 doctor jokes."
He used to tell me doctor jokes. That was our thing. And that's probably how I became a comic. Because every time I saw him, he lived about 2 hours away, and we just expected each other to have a new joke.
And that's going to be the other half of, like, most jokes, because you have like guy goes into a bar, guy goes into a doctor.
Yeah, pretty much. I know dozens of them. You want to hear some?
Sure. Yeah.
Okay, give me a number, 2, 3, I don't care.
I'll do 10. There you go.
10? Okay. Okay. 10. Okay, they have to get a laugh?
Yeah, do it like the world record. If we don't laugh, then they don't count. Yeah, do 10 with a laugh.
Okay. Guy goes to the doctor, and he says, "Every time I sneeze, I get an erection." And the doctor says, "What have you been taking for it?" And the guy says, "Pepper."
Yeah.
Okay, guy goes to the doctor, and he says, "Every time I sneeze..." No, wait. Oh, no, I'm out. I thought I'd come more, but I guess... Guy goes to the doctor, and the doctor says, "I've got bad news. You don't have long to live." And the guy says, "Well, how long have I got?" And the doctor says, 10. And the guy says, 10 what? And the doctor says, 9. 8.
That stinks.
7. Yeah. Guy goes to the doctor. He says, "I swallowed a chicken bone." He says, "Are you choking?" He says, "No, I'm serious."
I would never choke about that.
A guy goes to the doctor. He says, "It hurts when I touch here, hurts when I touch here, and hurts when I touch here." Doctor says, "Your finger's broken." Guy goes to the doctor. He gives him 6 weeks to live. The guy can't pay his bill, so he gives him another 6 weeks. Guy goes to doctor. Doctor says, "Take off your clothes, stick out your tongue, stand by the window." Guy says, "Why?" Doctor says, "Because I'm mad at my neighbor." Guy goes to doctor. He says, "One minute I feel like a wigwam, next minute I feel like a teepee." Doctor says, "You're too tense." 4 years old, I heard that. Guy goes to doctor. He's got 2 carrots in his nose, 2 celeries in his ears. Doctor looks at him and says, "You haven't been eating right."
Oh, man, that's so fucking stupid.
That's really, because up until this point, it's been an intellectual festival going on.
It's like a Mensa Fest, right?
Yeah, we're right.
Guy goes to the doctor, and he says, I've got bad news. You've got cancer, and you've got Alzheimer's. And the guy thinks for a minute, and he says, well, at least I don't have cancer. Guy goes to the doctor. He says, I cut off all my fingers. The doctor says, did you bring them? He says, no. He says, idiot, we could have sewed them right back on. Why didn't you bring them? He says, idiot, I couldn't fucking pick them up. Yeah. Fuck you.
Yeah, give me the finger on my head.
Exactly. A guy wakes up in the hospital and he says, I can't feel my legs. And the doctor says, that's because we cut your arms off. Of course you can't feel. You have no arms. How are you going to feel your legs? A lady goes to the doctor and she says, my husband has really bad dandruff. And the doctor says, give him some Head and Shoulders. And she says, how do you give shoulders? Maybe. Yeah.
It's pretty difficult.
A guy goes to the doctor. His asshole is this big around.
Yikes.
Yeah. And the doctor says, what have you been up to? He says, I got fucked by an elephant. He says, wait a minute. An elephant's dick is long and thin. He says, yes, but he fingered me first.
That'd be like this, wouldn't it?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, it's like elephant toe.
Okay, I got one more.
It's way worse than camel toe.
A guy goes to the doctor, and the doctor says, you have to stop masturbating. And the guy says, why? And the doctor says, because it's distracting the shit out of me.
There you go. That's got to be at least 10. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes, hello everyone. Hello. Hi, thank you so much for being here, and let's give a big hand to Geechy Guy. And we've come up with a fantastic show in honor of him. I'm Penny Wiggins.
Yay.
Thank you.
She's amazing. I'm Kelly Clinton.
Well, Kelly was supposed to be here, but she doesn't feel well, so she's not.
Oh, coming. I'm Amy Solomon.
You're Amy Solomon.
I'm Amy Solomon.
Yeah, you're Amy Solomon.
I was Geechy's roommate.
Yeah, she was Geechy's roommate and friend, and I've been his friend for too long. I mean, a long time, so yes.
Enough to have all those pictures of you.
No, I know, right? So we have a fantastic show, and we wanted to let you know there's karaoke afterwards. DJ Snow is going to be in the corner, and you guys didn't even play my walk-on music. What happened there? Let's do it now. It's never too late, right?
Walk a little bit.
Yeah, come on, everybody. Never. Okay,
that's great.
Thanks.
Thank you.
I went too far.
Thank you.
I went too far
Fabulous.
With that. All right.
Fabulous.
Now, we want to also tell you this is a fishbowl right here. And in this fishbowl are 30 of Geechy Guy's favorite jokes. All of his jokes that he loved are not all of them. Well, some of them are in here. And so some of you, we're going to call you three at a time to come up and tell his joke on stage. Mm-hmm. And my friend Carla Quist thought of this. So isn't it a great idea?
So great.
I know.
Everybody gets to be a part of it.
I know. And then we also have bags for everybody as you leave that you'll take with you, and there'll be something special afterwards. And so without further ado, we're going to get the show rolling.
Want to do an example of a joke?
Yes, we'll do you want to see an example of a joke? All right, let's
just
do
so
one.
Just so you know what we're doing. All Lots right. of activities and fun things for you guys today.
All right, Amy, I'll pick one for you.
Oh, gosh, that means I got to get
these. Here you go.
Hold on a minute. All right, guys, this is one of Geechy's jokes. Oh, it's a long read. No, I'm just kidding. Ha.
All right.
I'm against drugs because my mom used to do a lot of drugs before I was born. I think we should all say no to drugs because that drives the prices down. Hey, am I as funny as him? No.
Okay, one time a guy hit our mobile home. He rear-ended us, went through our back window, landed on our kitchen table, and went through the front windshield. Homewrecker.
Rude. That's going to be what you guys are going to be doing once we pull your name out of the little hat thingy.
A lot of fun. We're going to have some trivia about Geechy, so get your, don't look it up. So, all right, without further ado, please welcome our first singer, Anne Martinez.
So I met Geechy Guy doing these afternoon shows that we used to do at the Suncoast in Samstown a few years ago. And I was new to town. I didn't know anybody. And I was really, really nervous. And the one thing I really liked about Geechy Guy is that he just didn't care. If you had this incredible resume or if you were brand new in town, he just treated everybody with dignity and respect. And that was one of my favorite memories of him. Another favorite memory I have of Geechy is I asked him once, what's a really good joke I could tell, you know, if I had to, because sometimes, you know, you get put on the spot. And he said, here's a good one, and everyone's going to really like it. And this was the joke. He said, what's Moby Dick's dad's name? Papa Boner. This joke has seen me through many awkward times. But another thing, he gave me a great compliment once. He said, you know, I like that you sing songs that are for guys and you don't change the lyrics to make it work for you. And at first I thought, maybe she's a guy too. And then I thought, no, I think she's a girl. And this was the second time I met him. And I said to him, well, I'm a girl. And he's like, I thought so. And then he just walked away. Thus began our friendship. But here's a great guy song. And yes, I am a girl. And it just made me think of him and what an incredible life he led. So let's do it, guys. Come on.
Fast women, slow gin. You got me right here in this mess that I'm in. Just look at all this trouble I'm in. But I just can't help myself. Fast women will make you high. Too much gin, oh baby, you know that's just gonna make me cry. I feel so bad. But I just can't help myself. I've been a puppet, pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. Been up and down, over and out. But I know one thing. But this heart, it's never gonna bite it. But if there's nothing coming here this July, I'm gonna roll myself up in a great big ball and fly. We'll be right back. I won't bite. If there's no kind in this delight, I'm gonna roll myself up in a great big ball.
Martinez, everybody, Ann Martinez. That was, oh my God, that was amazing. Show's over. Good night. Just kidding. That's kidding. Okay, so we're gonna go in and out, make it happy, sad, happy, sad. And so here's our next thing is trivia. How well did you know Geechy Guy? All right, so, and you're going to get a little prize. Does anyone know the name? And if you know him, like if you're his roommate, you don't shout the shit out. Okay. What are the name of his two cats that he had? Wow, you guys really don't know this guy, do you? Oscar. Who said Oscar? Here, get up here. Come on. Get up here. Oscar's won. Yes, give him a big hand. Gary, you don't have to come on stage. Okay, just come on stage. That's all right. Okay. That's one of the cats. What's the other cat's name?
Emmy.
Emmy. Oscar and Emmy. Here we have a present. Don't go anywhere. We have a present for you, and here it is. It's a drug test, you know, just being around Geechy. You never know. So, all right, shut up. Don't give away my secrets. Damn, I'll give it up for our first trivia. Yay. And now we will be playing a video.
Hi, Ray Romano here. About 32 years ago, I got a spot on Star Search, the talent competition show, and I flew to L.A. to go up against whoever had won the week before, and I found out it was a comic named Geechy Guy. I didn't know who he was. All I knew was he won the last 5 weeks in a row. He was going for his sixth win in a row when I got there, and I thought to myself, oh, he's out of material. He's done the show 5 times? How many more jokes can he have? He had quite a few. I was on a plane home the next morning. He destroyed me. It was fun. We talked about it off stage. He was a great guy. And over the years, about 2 more times, maybe our paths crossed. And we would laugh and reminisce about the time that he put me away. A true pro and really a good guy. And sorry that he's gone, because he's going to be missed.
All right, that was some guy. I don't know him. Oh, do you see these lovely flowers? These are from Lance Burton. I know, isn't that lovely? And okay, so guess what time it is? It is fishbowl joke time. So if you put your name in here, then we're gonna pick your name. Come on up to the stage, and unlike Gary, you can come on stage. Okay. Our first person is Maria Gara. Come on up, Maria. We have Jordan Rooks. How many times did you put your name in the same fishbowl? And all right. We have Tawny. So come on up to the side over here. And this is the first time doing this, so let's see how it goes, right? Jordan, get up here. What are you waiting for, Christmas? Where's Maria? Maria, come on up. All right. Okay, I'm going to do it right here. You can speak into this microphone. All right, Maria, grab a joke. Okay. Just one. All right.
I'm so nervous.
Don't be nervous.
If an armless guy has a gun, is he armed?
Give it up for Maria. Good job, Maria. All right, this is Jordan Rooks.
Oh, shit. Okay. Saw a weird sign that said, "Don't even think about parking here." Yeah, so I parked there without even thinking about it.
All
This is Tani. She made the balloons, by the way.
I have one thing in common with gay guys. We have the same amount of sex with women.
All right. Okay. Isn't that fun? Okay, and if you change your mind, you want to tell a joke, come on up. And we have our first speaker for the day, his roommate and his dear friend. Please give it up for Tex.
Geechy Guy. You know, everybody knows him as a comic, but I knew the other side of a Geechy Guy. He was crazy, he was funny, and he was great to hang out with. He was quirky, and there'll never be another one like him. And I'm going to miss the hell out of him, and I don't have much else to say. It's, you know, I'm probably the last person on this earth that spoke to him, and every time I think about it, it breaks my heart.
Oh my God, give it up for Tex, you're so fucking quick. All right, all right, all right. We're gonna move the, are these in your way? Yeah. All right, how about now? How about, no? All right, we're just gonna, how about over here? All right, I don't know. How about now, huh?
That was really,
is that better?
Really
is that
graceful,
better?
Graceful.
Sorry about, should we start the show over so that you can, sorry about that, everyone, on this part. All right, so now we are, what's next, Amy?
There's going to be a video.
A video, yay, a video. Okay.
I don't remember how or where I met the Geechy Guy. We might have done a gig together, me and him, and I think maybe Bob Zaney. But whatever, we liked each other right away, of course. And my girlfriend and I were going to Las Vegas. I was doing a show, but it wasn't at Hooters. It was somewhere else. But the Geech had a room at Hooters. And I guess he lived there for a long time with his wife. And at some point she said, I don't want to live in a room in Hooters anymore. So he had this open room. He said, you're welcome to use it while you're in Las Vegas. So my girlfriend Emily and I showed up at Hooters and went to the room and went to unpack. And all of a sudden she screams with a laugh. She was putting stuff in the closet and she turns around and holds out, there was a rubber chicken hanging in the closet. And if that doesn't tell the story of Geechy Guy, I don't know why I think that's so fucking funny. But who has a rubber chicken in their closet? It had to be the Geech. And I got such a kick out of the guy. And I'm so sad to hear of his passing. But that's one less guy telling these disgusting jokes. So as the field lowers, we said goodbye to Gilbert and said goodbye to Geech. And Henny's long gone. So I'm getting a lot of the space for the joke-telling industry to myself. Of course, nobody wants it. Because what good is it except for things like this where we can laugh our balls off at the filthy, filthy, fun jokes. Thanks for thinking of me, and love to the Geechy Guy. Much love.
All right, that was Jackie Martling from Howard Stern. You guys know who that? No. All right, we have our second speaker. Ladies and gentlemen, a dear friend. I don't know who he is, but let's give it up for Gary Tyson. Where are you, Gary? Gary, oh, he just can't stay off the stage, can he? All right, come on up. Great that you know you can, all right.
Okay, I'll make mine real quick. Geechy and I go back about 40 years. Early on in his career, he would open for me, and later on, I would open for him. We wrote a show together called Too Funny, the One-Man Show, So Good It Takes Two Guys to Do It, and we toured that for a year. We would talk on the phone, I'm not exaggerating, 15 times a day. And one of my favorite Geechy lines was, he said, my mom always thought that I was an idiot savant. She was half right. So here's some proof of that. And I know people who know him know what his memory was really like. I was coming back from New York in my car, and I'm driving on I-80, and Geechy called, and he said, where are you? And I said, I don't know. I'm on I-80 in Pennsylvania somewhere. And I'm driving, and I see a sign. I said, I'm near Clearview. Swear to God, my wife's here. She'll back me up. He says, oh, exit 111? I said, Geechy, you cannot possibly know what exit Clearview is in Pennsylvania. And we get to the next exit, it's fucking 111. But he had a follow-up. He was great at taglines, right? He goes, did you know that Clearview has the highest elevation of any city east of the Mississippi? That was Geechy. And I miss him a fucking lot.
Gary Tyson.
Hey everybody, I wish I could be there today. We all love Geechy Guy, and I don't know what I can add or say that people here haven't already said besides he's a great pickpocketer. Geechy Guy, God bless him, had the best teeth, didn't he? He had big, big teeth. I used to say you could scrape your teeth and get fucking high. One thing I remember about Geechy Guy, I was just about to do, this is really true, Star Search. And this is like in 1990, whatever it was, when I was going to do Star Search, and I was at the Improv, where I always ate shit. Every time I went on the Improv, I ate shit. And I came off, I ate shit, and Geechy Guy came up to me and he says, oh my God, you're getting ready for your Star Search. And I said, yeah, well, that's how it's going to be. It's not well. He says, you got this. You got this. No one's going to beat you on Star Search. I mean, Star Search was made for you. I don't even know why they're going to film it, because you're going to win the whole thing. I said, thank you. Thank you, Geechy Guy. And then I lost to Bob Zaney the first fucking time. Bob Zaney. Sounds funny, right? Bob Zaney. It's an actual comic named Bob Zaney. and we all miss and love Geechy Guy. If there's time, this is when you cut my tape. If there's time, I want to share one of my favorite Geechy Guy jokes. He would say, Wilt Chamberlain had sex with over 30,000 women, right? He had a book where he wrote 30,000 women he had sex with. And Geechy Guy would say he was in a little town, and he'd drive by, and it was like, population 29,800. And Geechy would say, wouldn't it be great? I could actually drive by a town and say, you see that town? I fucked it. That's Geechy Guy. God bless you, and God bless all you for being there. I wish I could be there. All right, Geechy. Tee-hee-hee-hee.
Give it up for Carrot Top. And we have our next speaker. And our next speaker has been in this town longer than anyone I know. Please give it up for Dennis Bono.
Now, I didn't really know Geechy Guy until about 14 or 15 years ago when he first came on the show. And somebody said, boy, you're really going to get a kick out of this guy. So he came out and he was quirky and awkward. And my audience took about 15 seconds for them to fall in love with him. And he was, and I'm going to say something. He made an impact on my life, and I can tell you why. You know, we live in a town where right now there's a lot of homeless people. And a lot of, you know, that are on the corner with signs and he told me the story. So, and I said he made an impact because when I pull up to a light and there's somebody on the corner holding a sign that says, I need money for food, I start to laugh. And people look at me and go, wow, what an insensitive bastard this guy must be. And I still do it. And the reason is Geechy told me this story. And I told it over and over. Pulled up to the light. There's a guy with a sign, a homeless guy, said, this is Vegas, baby. You know, holding a sign said, I need money for food. Rolled the window down, I'm going to give him $5. And I said, well, how do I know you're not going to use this to gamble? And he goes, oh, no, I got gambling money. Only in Vegas. I've been telling that story forever. He's made an impact on my life, and every time I'm stuck at a light and I start to giggle, people look at me and go, look at that insensitive bastard. And it's all because of Geechy Guy. We miss him.
Yeah. Great job. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Everybody doing all right so far? All right. Oh, we're so happy to have everybody here. Penny, the group, the crew, Jerry, everybody. Eric, they worked so hard on this event, and we're just so happy. We all love Geechy. Come on. Okay? On that note, we have an incredible singer coming up next. And not only that, she's also an incredible person as well. We're gonna hear it for her right now. Kelly Vaughn.
Hey everybody. I have a couple Geech stories. One is, oh my God, one time he called me when I was in Wisconsin. I was doing a gig with a band in Wisconsin. And he was in Ohio. He calls me up, and we were just talking about him. We were doing sound check. And all of a sudden, my phone rings, and it's Geechy Guy. And I'm like, oh my God, speak of the devil, it's him. And I answer it. And he goes, hey, we're close to each other. I see that you're in Wisconsin. I'm in Ohio. I'm like, oh yeah, that's like North Las Vegas and Henderson. So close. And he goes, well, I'm up here because my sister passed. And I said, I'm sorry. And he goes, oh, you didn't do it. I'm like, what? He goes, yeah, the cops cleared you. I was like, I didn't know what to say. I was like, only Geech could do that, right? And then we had a really, really long drive together once. And he was telling me many stories, but he was telling me that he didn't get laid till like, I don't know, late 30s, early 40s. And already he had been on The Late Show, the Tonight Show, the Johnny Carson Show, the Jay Leno Show, and also David Letterman Show. He's been on all these shows. He says, so basically what I'm saying, it was easier for me to be on national TV than to get laid. I'm like, Geech, I got nothing. I don't know what to say to you. He'll be missed, greatly missed, and this is for him, as best as I can do. If I should stay, well, I would only be in the way. And so I'll go, and yeah, I know that I will think of you each step of my way. But sweet memories, it's all I have, and all I'm taking with me. Goodbye, oh please don't cry, we both know I'm not what you need. You kind, and I hope you had all that you ever dreamed of. Oh, we wish you joy, we wish you happiness, but above all this, we wish you love.
another speaker come out. This person is amazing. Wonderful, wonderful human being. Beautiful, stunning, an empath. It's me. I'm the next speaker. My name's Amy. I was Geechy's roommate, will always be, and also he was my friend. So I just have a few things to say, but I haven't put my glasses on. Oh God, I'm getting old. I think I'm gonna just try to bring the personal side out to Geech, because you know everybody worked with him and did comedy. We got to see like raw Geech at home. And I have to say, whatever happens behind closed doors, is that saying? It happens behind closed doors, you don't know about it. But the truth of the fact is, Geechy's Geech. However you knew him is exactly the way he was at home. Just amazing. So I'll just tell you one great story is Tex and I, we had fun a lot. So every time Geechy wrote one of his shows, whether it be a dirty show or a clean show, he wanted to practice with us. So we got like first dibs, haha. And we did it in the living room, had dinner, and he had his little paper that looked just like this. And he just went. He's like, all right, this is my dirty show. And he would just stand in front and just like perform like it was his show. So I found that to be lucky. I was lucky to get that out of Geech. I got all the rawness of that. To show what a lover Geechy was, we had this stray cat. I would go buy food because he hated going to the store. I know. And I'm going to do Geechy. He'd come out. We'd look outside, feed the cat, and he'd go, hey, baby. Hey, baby. He just was so loving. He loved that cat, and all it did was hiss at us and attack us. He didn't give a shit. He's like, hey, baby. And it's like he didn't even care. So, I mean, to live with this guy, he kept to himself a lot. He's just a great guy. I mean, Tex is getting emotional. So am I. So, anyway, I just wanted to bring that personal side to him. He used to come out of the room and be like, hey, guys, you guys need anything? We're like, no, Geech, we're all right. We don't need anything. And he goes, okay, thank you. And then I said, Geechy. So today, I'm the one, Geechy. I'm the one that's going to say thank you for you.
Hey, everybody. This is Murray the Magician. And it was really important to me that I sent a video in for Geechy Guy's memorial, as I'm sure everyone there is shocked as I am, gone way, way too young. The guy was a legend in this town. His one-liners were unbelievable. He was the only comedian I saw that for the first 30 seconds to a minute, the audience had no clue what was going on and was like, what is this guy? And then the next 10 minutes to half an hour, they just loved him. And I love you, Geechy Guy. Looking down on us and to his family and everyone else, he was just a legend and we're gonna miss him a lot. So take care and God bless.
Geechy, where the hell is Geechy Guy? For fuck's sake, he got me knocked up. I'm knocked up now and there's nobody here to be the daddy. Hello, would you like to be the daddy? I'm 50% sure it's his though. Would you like to be the daddy? No, all right. Just like Geechy. Hey, well, we played shuffleboard together, you know? You know what I'm saying? He got his puck in me. We played puck. Well, anyway, I met him on the carnival. You look like you would not be a daddy. I'm just saying. You know what he did? You know what he did? He paid for the buffet on the ship for me. He paid for that. That's how he treated me, like a lady. I'm just looking for a daddy. My name is Kathy with a K. If anyone here wants to be a... You look like you could be a daddy. Spank me like a daddy. Get over here, you. You know what? I'm just going to bring you on stage. Get up there. This is Mark Wilde, everybody. Give it up for Mark Wilde, and I'll be seeing you later. Hi, daddy. Would you like to be a daddy in the carnival with me? All right, whatever. Go. Fuck you. Shut up. Don't even
Jesus
look
Christ,
me.
Kathy, with a fucking K. God, that was frightening.
You look like I'm out.
Keep it moving, Kathy.
Peace out. Peace out. I'll see some of you later.
Yeah, get your peace out of here.
You look sexy.
We need that peace out.
Hey,
give it up for this band. But I want to highlight the guitar drummer combo. You weren't at the last rally. How are we supposed to keep the movement going if you guys don't show up? They kind of look like the Proclaimers after chemo. You don't look like you could walk even 50 miles, bro. So I'm wearing these sunglasses. I want you to think I'm sad, but I'm actually wearing these because people have told me when I wear them, I look like James Franco. And I'm just now realizing that's not a plus anymore, so I'm gonna kill these bitches. I wanna do a couple deep cuts of Geech's to open up. Two of my favorites. He said, I wanna be just famous enough so that the guy that shoots me doesn't get famous. Isn't that a great one? And then he said, you know, for your NBA fans, you like the basketball, you realize when New Jersey moved to Brooklyn, they had to get a new jersey. Because the old jersey said New Jersey. I got 2 minutes if you want to work it out. It's up to you. So we lost Geech on a Wednesday. And I don't know if you know this about Geech, but Geech was an avid Kansas City Chiefs fan. Did you know that about him? So we lost him on Wednesday, and on Friday, the Kansas City Chiefs in the season opener at home got their asses stomped by the fucking Detroit Lions. And I was watching that game thinking, thank God Geech is gone, because this would have fucking killed him. So if you think about it, he only lost 2 days. Is that too much math for you motherfuckers? I'm going to miss Geech a lot, man. Geech and I got really close. I used to pick him up. We'd go on those late night drives. And he would call me up and go, hey, what are you doing? I'm going to miss that so much. He'd just call you, hey, what are you doing? Hey, what are you doing? That was it, man. I'd pick him up. One of the last times we went out, we went up to Blue Diamond. We would either go to Blue Diamond or Boulder City, the two humane places left in the area. And the last time we went to Blue Diamond, there was just this burrow just kind of lying on the asphalt. You know, they'll be on the yards and stuff. And we were like, and we circled around. And I was like, we should probably go back and check on that burrow. So we pulled up, and I swear to God, Geech rolled down the window and went, you okay, little fella? That was Geech, man. So I'm gonna miss that motherfucker, man, and I hope he's looking down, and I hope he's getting a kick out of this. Thanks a lot, everybody.
Give it up for Mark Wilde. Mark Wilde, very funny comedian. And now guess what time it is, people? Fishbowl joke time. Come on up, Sparky. This is Sparky, everybody. I think you met her on your way in. Sparky's going to tell one of her jokes, and then she's going to pick let's pick our three names first so I can get them on the side. So we're going to pick some names here. All right. We have Brenda Williams. Come on down, Brenda. Be on standby. Dennis Blit. Oh, why are you even in here? Sorry, Dennis. You've already done your share. Melanie Kramer. And we have Dennis Bono. I think somehow these got mixed up. Did you really put your name in there, Dennis?
He really did.
All right.
Oh no. I think
all right. Let's just give other people a fucking chance. Stephen Pearl. All right. Melanie Kramer, Brenda Williams, and Stephen Pearl. And now Sparky's going to tell her joke. Don't come up yet. And go ahead, Sparky.
This one's for Johnny Katz with his fancy cars.
You know, they say that a person's car reflects their personality. I don't have a car.
All right, Sparky, you want to grab the fishbowl? Sparky, you can grab the fishbowl. And then come on up, Brenda. Brenda? fucking Lance. That's fucking, could he have gotten smaller fucking flowers? All right, Brenda?
All right, here you go, Brenda. Pick a joke. I'm just kidding. Sorry, Lance. Wherever. No, he's alive still, right? Okay. I'm sorry. Sorry. Don't tell him I said that.
My friend is a psychic. He's also a psycho. He's both. He can predict your future, then follow you around and make sure it happens that way.
All right. Melanie Kramer.
I didn't even put my name in the hat, so don't expect much.
That's a good way to intro yourself, Melanie. Come on, Melanie.
The only pickup line that works for me is, I bet you $600 you won't sleep with me.
Melanie Kramer. All right, and Stephen Pearl, one of my other favorite comics.
Thank you.
Steve Pearl.
I got one.
All right.
God, this is all going to be Carlos Mencia's material in another hour. Okay. Oh, I got another 3 hours. I know you think you recognize me, and I'll tell you where it is. You recognize me from my modeling career. Yeah, I was the third one over on the evolution chart.
Stephen Pearl! Thank you, and give it up for Sparky, who's very sparky. And now a fantastic singer. Who is it? Oh, yeah. All right. Let's give it up for Stephanie Calvert.
Is it on? Oh, there it is. Hi, everyone. I'm delivering waters to the boys as well.
Hey, thank you, man.
I do multitasking.
It's amazing.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Here you go. Hi, husband.
Would you marry
me? I make
me?
Out with that guy. Hi. Oh, my gosh. I'm so happy to be here. I'm very, very, very honored that I could be part of this amazing celebration, because I know some of you know Geechy Guy a lot more, but I've had so many little run-in encounters with him that have been so lovely. And I remember when I first met him, he was wearing his velvet jacket, paisley, floral, whatever, with his hat on. And he was so nice to me. And I thought, oh my gosh, he likes me. He thinks I'm cool. And little did I know, like, he's very friendly with everyone. But for a second, I was really special, and I just thought, oh my gosh, that Geechy Guy thinks I'm cool. And I remember we were friends on Facebook, and I just thought I'd made it. And then he ended up being roommates with a couple of my best friends, like Jerry and Amy and Tex. And I, before we moved back here, I would come and stay with them. And Geechy was there, and like she said, he would just come out randomly with like no shirt on. And barefoot, and then he wore these shorts that just were completely ripped all the way up to here with no underwear on. And I just loved every minute of that. And I'm like, Geechy, that's cool. That's all right. I'm so happy. And I would cook for them, and then he'd come in and be like, okay, and then he'd just take his plate and take a couple bites and then go into his room with his shorts on. And I'll never forget. So here's some music that will hopefully inspire you to have a good day. A rooster says good morning with a cock-a-doodle-doo. Good morning. A horse's neigh is just his way of saying how are you. A lion roars hello, the owl say hi, and where and who. May I suggest you get undressed and show them your wazoo. The animals, let's talk dirty to the animals. Fuck you, Mr. Bunny, eat shit, Mr. Bear. If they don't love it, they can shove it. Frankly, I don't care. Oh, the animals, let's talk dirty to the animals. Up yours, Mr. Hippo, piss off, Mr. Fox. Go tell a chicken, suck my dick and give him chicken. The animals, let's talk dirty to the animals. From birds in the treetops to snakes in the grass.
tell an alligator bite my... No, never tell an alligator bite my... Yes, never tell an alligator bite my... Snatch! Thank you! Oh my gosh! Oh, I'm not done, Penny. This one inspires the most. It's very thoughtful. And I just wanted to take it down. That was really funny. But I wanted to get serious for a minute. Because if any joke reminds me the most of Geechy or any song, this one might be it. It's very serious, you guys. If you call yourself a diva, you better be a singer and not somebody cutting me in line. Oh, if you call yourself a diva, you better sing a solo and not be someone treating me unkind. If you call yourself a diva, it better be for reals and not some sad, pathetic kind of front. If you're selfish and you're thoughtless and you're broken and you're heartless, you're probably not a diva, you're a cunt. Cunt, 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 cunt.
Stephanie Calvert.
Now? Okay. Stephanie Calvert! Let her hear it!
Cunt!
Oh, I wasn't calling you the cunt. Oh, shit. Okay, and now I get to bring up this next guy. He's a phenomenal magician. He's a dear friend of mine. Do you know me? And he's very wonderful, and I love him. Let's give it up for Mr. Justin Flom.
Geechy was the GOAT, but it wasn't just his delivery that was amazing. It was his memory that was so incredible, and which is impressive because he smoked a lot of weed. And he would say, "I smoke weed for my glaucoma. I don't have it. I'm just trying to build up an immunity." Which is one of my favorite openers that he would do. And I'm really grateful for Geech, not just because of what he did for the comedy scene here in Las Vegas with his Friars Club and Dirty Joke Show and introducing me to amazing people like Matt Black, but also he was the first one to ever give me weed and start me on a long life journey of being a pothead. And the first time we're backstage after Dirty Joke Show, and he gave me my first joint, and I got wicked high because he had some strong shit. And I swore that I was stuck to my chair, and I was kind of freaking out in my head because I didn't think I was going to be able to stand up and leave. And I'm like, shit, everyone's going to get up and leave, and I'm not going to be able to leave. I'm stuck to my chair. Everyone gets up. I do get up, and I look at Geech, and I say, "I'm really high." And he said, "Okay."
And Geech was the man, so I miss him a lot. We love you, Geechy Guy.
Justin Flom.
Hi, everyone. I wish I could be there. I'd love to hear the stories that are being told. I'll be on a ship in the Caribbean celebration. I was actually supposed to work with Geechy the week he passed, apparently. We were going to work on the Carnival Spirit. I was excited about seeing him. We both like jokes, unlike a lot of you guys, and we'd exchange them all week, but I got there and they said he was sick. Obviously, I was shocked, like everyone, when he passed. I told this story on Facebook, so maybe some of you have seen it, but I was working at a Holly Hotel in Holly, Michigan, winter of 1984. They had a small room in the basement, maybe 60, 80 people. It was, I think, Thursday through Sunday. Thursday night, they had open mic night. They had five or six comics going up in front of me, a lot of them from Detroit. So about three guys had been up, and then the MC introduced a comic with a really unusual name. I'd never heard it. And he said it two or three times. The guy wasn't appearing. And then he jumped out from behind a small curtain in the back of the stage and scared the crap out of everybody, especially the MC. The MC almost had a heart attack. I laughed so hard, I almost peed my pants. He had gone, it was Geechy Guy, of course. He had gotten there at least 45 minutes to an hour early, to hid behind that curtain for an hour to jump out for this introduction to scare the crap out of everybody. I can't remember his set. I think he had one joke that really impressed me. But I remember thinking anyone that'll do all that to get a laugh is going to do okay. And I mentioned, you never know about the people we meet. I had no idea this gangly, awkward kid with a goofy name would be my friend and a comic I respected for almost 40 years. And I really miss you, I guess you, Geechy. If anyone knows how he got his name, please, where he got his name from, please let me know. I never ask him, but if any name ever fit a comic, Geechy Guy.
All right. I don't know who that was, but yeah. And our next speaker is Christine Wind. Are you here, Christine? Well, get on up here, sister, and don't you cry, because I know you want to. I haven't cried once. I'm just kidding. All right, it's Christine Wind.
Hello. Thank you so much, everyone, for being here and honoring Geechy Guy, and I am so in love with him. He was really my very best friend for about 33 years, and I met him in 1990. We started talking every day. And then he said that every single manager in his industry had quit on him, and he couldn't find one manager. And so he said, come down and be my manager. And I'm like, well, I've never done anything like this. And we traveled together, and we had so much fun. And one of the best parts is that I didn't get arrested. I really was thinking, for sure, I'm going to one of these days be arrested. Because we would go over like national borders, like up to Winnipeg, and I would put his little Levi jacket on that someone painted for him. And we'd be talking with the director of this border patrol place for about an hour. And then when I leave, I find I have a little film container in my front pocket. And then we'd fly somewhere, and we would go down some stairs, and he was so tall, and he would reach way up, and there he would have a joint. And it was still there. I'm like, when was the last time that you flew here? And it was a long time ago, but it was still sitting there. And he smoked it in the airport. So anyway, and then we get to the park right before we go over another border, and he pulls out this shovel that's folded up, and he folds digs, and he puts his stash in there. We go over the border, he's got another stash sitting over there, big coffee cans buried.
Just insane. Like, everywhere we went in the whole world, it was just like he had a stash somewhere. I thought you could write some pretty good series about this, his planning of where to stash this stuff. But I was there the day that he was going on his first show with Jay Leno, and the NBC limo was coming. He wanted to wear his little Bali patterned sweater, and he was really in love with this sweater, kind of like Linus. And so I said, you can't wear patterns on TV. You have to wear solids. And he started to cry, and I said, come on. And I poured shampoo on his head, and I said, it washes out. Just go over here and get in the shower, and it's all fine. And we went, and he was really funny. He was. Oh, but it's time to end. Okay, thank you.
Give it up for Christine.
Woo-hoo.
That was very
awesome,
awesome.
Christine. Thank awesome. You for coming. She came from far.
Okay, guess what time it is? Trivia. I think a lot of you are going to know this, and if you do know it, don't shout it out. I'm just kidding. You should. Okay, because we're going to throw some joke bombs, grenades your way. What does Geechy Guy mean? Crazy. All right, well,
that's
his roommate. You're out. Who else said it back there? You said it. All right, Christine.
So Geechy had this thing where obviously, the grenades, when he had a joke that people didn't laugh at, so he'd throw them out. These are mushy, so I hope I don't hurt anyone, but we're going to throw some Geechy grenades out at y'all, people.
Who else got a crazy guy back there? Come on up. Hurry up so you don't lose your
grenades. It's happening.
Don't you think this is clever? Grenades for... No?
Grenades for Geechy.
Here you go.
Here we go, Geechy. Woo!
All right. Wait, we had one more person over there. Get the hard ones. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. We have one more. One more.
Okay.
All right. Yeah, get the real ones. Okay. So now we're going to bring on another speaker. Are you ready for it? I'll get yours later. Let's give it up for Emily Cooper. So beautiful. You're a very pretty lady, Emily. And your matching pants. You can tell them who you are when you get up there.
Well, I can't get up here and say that I know Geechy very well or that I knew him, but I had a brief encounter with Geechy back in 2011. And by the way, it's nice to see all of you here today. You know, it really is. This is a special thing. It's a sad moment, but it's nice to see everybody come together like this. I told Dennis and Peggy Blair that I had a funny story to tell about Geechy, although I didn't really know him that well. So yesterday I got a call from Peggy, and she says, Emily, we have a video from Jackie Martling, and it sounds to me like it might be the story you're going to tell. So she said, does it have anything to do with a rubber chicken? And I said, actually, yes. So not only did he steal my material, he did it from the East Coast, and he even botched the story. So the good news is I'm here to tell you the real version of it. So I'm going to make it quick, but it was fun. In 2011, he was doing his Dirty Joke show at the Hooters Hotel, and I was there with Jackie, and he was so sweet. You know, he said, I insist that you all stay in my room. And I said, but where are you going to stay? Well, he said, I'll stay with a friend or something. And I said, you know, that's okay. No, he insisted. So we stayed in his room. We hung out with Bobby Slayton, was there that night, I remember, and we just had the funnest time. And Geechy was so sweet and warm, and he was funny. We just had the nicest night. We go up to the room, and you know, we're in a hotel, and I'm thinking, oh, this is a hotel room, right? So I'm thinking, okay, I'm gonna take a shower, and then I come out, and I said, oh yeah, I'm gonna go see if there might be a robe in the closet. So I go to where a robe would normally be in a hotel room, and I open up the closet and pull out a rubber chicken. You know, and it was just such a quintessential thing, and it just hit me. And I thought, damn, Jackie stole that, you know, he stole my joke, but I started, so then I thought, wait a second, there's got to be a reason and a meaning behind this, right? So I started Googling the whole meaning and the whole, what is the rubber chicken? Because it's a profound thing in comedy. And if you really Google it, nobody really knows the answer to it. So the answer to it that anyone can come up with is that the rubber chicken is funny because it was able to essentially diffuse any situation that was not funny, because it wasn't funny, because it was so absurd, right? But it's old school, you know, and that was the thing about the rubber chicken. So when I think about Geechy, he was an old school, even though he was young, and it's really hard. We've lost a lot of young comedians, right? I mean, my husband Pat Cooper just died 10 years after he retired. You know, so he was ready to go, and you know, it was hard to say bye to him, but it's hard to say bye to the era, and it's really hard to say bye to the Bob Sagetts and all of these young comedians, Gilbert, and all these guys. You know, that's what's really hard to deal with. But I think the moral of the rubber chicken is that it's a metaphor. Right, for it gives us an excuse to laugh, and laughter is important for our souls, and that's why we have to keep comedy going, and especially old school comedy. And these old school guys, you know, I have a feeling we love Sebastian Maniscalco, but he probably does not have a rubber chicken in his closet, you know. So I guess I'm getting tired now. It's been a long day. Oh, I wanted to say also, you know, the Rat Pack, for example. You know, I met Dennis Blair, and you know, I'm breaking Jackie's chops a little bit, but Dennis Blair I met through Jackie Martling when he did the Rat Pack show out in Bellport. That was an amazing show. But the Rat Pack show was comedy. They were a musical comedy show, right? We have to keep that whole thing going and that legacy. I talked to Dennis about it. You know, the old school era is ending, and I'm very passionate about keeping that going. But Geechy will live on because he was a good guy, and he is from the rubber chicken era. And, you know, I guess that's kind of what I'm trying to say here. And the bottom line here is that laughter feeds our souls. And I, you know, I had the privilege of living with Pat Cooper for 5 years and being married to him. He was an amazing guy who Jackie Martling actually introduced me to, as well as Geechy. You know, Jackie introduced me to Geechy. I got to know him. So I just want to tell you all that Oscar Wilde said something very important. Life is too important to be taken seriously, and that's the importance of comedy. And I would like to thank all of you for what you've done for this event. And I would like to give Penny a rubber chicken.
Wow, well, thanks. It's not my first, but thank you. Appreciate that.
I couldn't believe they had one at the dime store down the street. I was shocked. Thank you all. This was a pleasure.
Give it up for Emily Cooper. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Sandy fucking Knights.
Hi. I just wanted to make a quick comment that what a wonderful world it was to have Geech in it, right? And my favorite thing about him wasn't that he was just brilliant and funny, brilliantly funny, but it was that he unapologetically told his friends that he loved them. Like, he would look at you and be like, I love you. And that will always be my favorite thing about him. And the last time I saw him, he was wearing a shirt that said, "What would Scooby do?" And so I want you all to just think of what would Geechy do. Tell each other that you love them. I think
goodbye. I see friends shaking hands. How do you do?
Nights. Give it up for Sandy fucking Knight. That's her intro. No, I didn't bring that up.
Hey, this is the Unknown Comic, and if you remember me, you are old. But like most of you, I just want to say, I love Geechy Guy. All right, let me take this bag off my head. There we go. Anyway, let me try this again. All right, there we go. Not much difference, is there? Hey, anyway, I just want to say I'm joining all you guys on this very sad and special occasion, saying goodbye to our good buddy, Geech. And I say, what can you say about Geechy Guy that hasn't already been said about Mike Tyson? I mean, let's face it, Mike Tyson, he was a heavyweight in comedy, and boy, did he know how to deliver a punchline. And but I love the guy, and he had so many classic one-liners. My favorite of his, I don't know if it's been said by anybody so far, but my favorite one-liner of his was when he said, yeah, I went on a date yesterday and with this girl, and we're driving by this trailer park, and I told her I lived there. I was joking, but someday, yeah. Anyway, I was trying to think of a one word that best describes Geechy Guy for me, and it was a sweetheart. He was a sweetheart. Okay. He was a total sweetheart in every way. He always exuded warmth and friendliness and love for comedy and his friends. And I didn't see him a lot, even though we worked. I first met him, actually, I first met him like almost 30 years ago. It was so long ago. We actually met at a pay toilet. He was crawling under and I was crawling under and we hit heads. And we've been friends ever since. But we always talked every few months. He would call me with a joke or I would call him with a new joke that we had heard. The last time he called me was a few months ago. Told me this joke. Did you hear about the new medicine for depressed lesbians? I said, no. He said, yeah, it's called tricoxygen. But that was our Geech. Like I said, he was like a comedy angel. And I just want to join you all in saying goodbye to this comedy angel and this sweetheart. I love you, and like so many others, I'm going to miss you. Bye-bye, Geech.
Almost got me, motherfucker. I give it up for Marie Langston, the unknown known comic. Are you guys having fun? Sad fun? Fun sad? Sad fun. Is that a new word? Sad fun, right? Okay. We only have another hour and 20 minutes, and then we're done. I'm just kidding. We don't have very many things left. We're going to have food outside. We're going to do karaoke. You guys ready for that? Come on! All right. Now I get to bring on a dear friend of mine, John D. Domenico.
Buddy. Wow. Look at this turnout. Is this incredible? I'm only going to talk for 2 or 3 hours. Is that okay? Geechy Guy. Geechy Guy. What a great name. Geechy Guy. And his hair was like a llama. It was like a llama. Or an alpaca. I'm not sure.
I'm really honored to be here. Jerry asked me to speak, and there's such an incredible lineup. I never thought in my entire life I would follow Murray Langston. I used to watch him on the Gong Show in high school. But I'm it's one of those days where you get to see a lot of people don't usually see, and you get to honor an amazing comedian with this incredible mind, this insanely quick wit, who wrote jokes in a way I don't think anyone else did. A lot of people do one-liners, but he was able to remove every single piece of fat from a joke and construct it in a way that you got it. It was so clear. It was so funny. He had this encyclopedic mind for jokes, obviously, but he also had this, he was a great comedy historian. And the few times that I got to really sit down and talk with him, we talked about, obviously, comedy, but he loved sketch comedy, which I thought was great. He loved SCTV and Saturday Night Live and the Groundlings and all these sketch groups, which, you know, Jerry and I were discussing the fact that it's unusual because he was a stand-up. He loved all that wonderful sketch stuff. And one of the things about Geechy Guy, to me, when I got to meet him, was like, wow, a lot of comedians don't stay in the game, especially the comedians from his class, and he worked really hard, and he was so passionate about comedy and about performing live and all of these amazing things. And everyone knows how incredibly funny he was, and obviously club bookers knew that, and cruise bookers and comedy connoisseurs. So he was loved, and he found a home here in Las Vegas. And that's one of the things I wanted to focus on, is because he really loved Las Vegas. He loved this town for the same reason many of the performers and non-performers in this town love it. It's because this is an amazing entertainment community that supports entertainers. For all of you, true. For the entertainers that are here, you know, New York, LA, all the musicians are in the same silo, and all the comedians are in the same silo, and all the dancers are in the same silo. But Las Vegas, everybody gets together. Everybody supports each other. It's just one big family, one big dysfunctional family, for sure. But it's a big family, and everybody, it doesn't matter who you are, everybody comes out and goes to the shows and supports their friends. And Geechy Guy was a friend. And the very first time I got to meet him, because I was very excited, he's been around for a really long time, I was like, hey, Geech, I'm John D. Domenico's
you're the Trump guy. And I'm like, yes, I am, Geechy. Yes, I am. And I just thought, I was very flattered he knew who I was. But then again, he's from details that you've heard from people. He's way ahead of you on a lot of things because a guy just has an encyclopedic knowledge. One of the things I thought was great that he calls Las Vegas home, and that's something we all want. We all want a home, and we all want a place to come back to after being on the road. And, you know, he had a great sense of community. I met him at one of the Monday's Dark shows where, you know, Mark Chinook has put all this together and the space together. Makes it possible for musicians, comedians, dancers, amazing singers like Ann Martinez and Sandy and all these great singers we have. Please give them a round of applause. They really deserve it. But this is the perfect place to honor a fellow performer in the space. It's our Las Vegas Community Center, and we love each other, and we support each other, and I love Geechy, and I'm so happy that I got to meet him about, I guess it was 5 or 6 years ago, and he's brought a lot of joy and a lot of laughs and a lot of people together. Like we're right now. And you can see the diverse group of people he's brought together. And he's had a really big impact. So thank you. And thank you for making me laugh. And thank you for this opportunity to honor this great guy.
John DiDomenico, give it up for John.
Hi, you guys. I wish I was in Las Vegas with you right now, toasting to the genius of the one-liners. Geechy guy. Man, he was a cool dude. He loved pinball, by the way. That's why I put one of my favorite pinball machines in the shot. He reached out to me on Facebook to tell me what a pinball enthusiast he was, and he liked my pinball machines, so I thought I'd put that in the shot. The other thing that he and I had in common that he always brought up whenever I saw him, that he was on Star Search, right? He had the most appearances by any comedian ever on Star Search, 10 appearances, and he did not win the whole thing. I had the least possible appearances on Star Search and won the whole thing. And he always brought it up kind of begrudgingly and busting my balls. So 10 appearances for Geech, no win. 4 appearances for me, yes. I just made this about me, somehow, at another guy's funeral. What an ego this fucking guy has. Geech, I love you. You are the king of the one-liners. Love all you guys in Vegas, which I was there. Toast, Geech. Take care.
Mike Ciccone, give it up for Mark O'Toole.
Hey, everybody, how are you? Very quick story about Geechy. About 2 years ago when I started my show, I said, Geechy, will you do my show? I need a strong closer. I never put a comedian on. Geechy said, sure. Shows up at the theater, comes on. I said, okay, Geechy, do 10 minutes. He says, great. So he's closing the show. I said, can you tell me the joke that you're going to do so I can outro you? You know, he says, yeah, I'm going to do a joke about a clock. And so Geechy did 10 minutes, and I'm sitting there waiting. Geechy, the band's waiting, and waiting for the clock joke. Never heard nothing about a clock. And so Geechy did another 3 minutes, and I'm waiting for the clock joke. And then he turns to me, and he looks at me, and he goes, hey, Mark, I'm sorry, I'm running over. Okay, so this is the last joke, and there was no mention of a clock. And there Geechy stood on stage. We had to turn off all the lights in the theater. He pulled his seat up, and he sat in the middle of the stage. And the band left. People started walking out of the theater, and there was still no mention about a fucking clock. And so Geechy closed the show with the lights off, sitting there. We turned the mics off. People left, and he still sat in the middle of the theater, in a chair by himself in the dark, telling jokes. And that's the way we ended the show. And he had the last laugh. I love you, Geechy guy.
Mark O'Toole.
And now his one-time ship manager, who now needs a new comedian. So if you're interested, please. Tony Camacho.
Hi, gang. Yeah. Well, I tell you, I had to cancel, and this is no joke, about $70,000 worth of work that Geechy had booked for the ships. So if anybody's a loser, believe me, I was hurt. I was very hurt. But one thing I can tell you about Geechy, he would call me and say, listen, I'm going to be doing either Mark's show or Dennis's show. He would say that, come over, I'm going to be doing a show this afternoon. I go over, and before, like most comics, I say, well, what are you going to do? I don't know, I'll do something. 2 minutes before he's going to go on stage, so Geechy, you know what you're going to do? No, I didn't think about it yet. And he'd go up there and do 5-10 minutes of material that nobody has heard before, you know? And if you tell Geechy a joke, he never laughed. He'd always say, oh, that's funny. Oh, that's funny. It was his answer, you know, to everything. But my favorite Geechy joke was, and as you know, Geechy was a big guy. And he said, you know, people see me, they see how big I am, they see how big my hands are. And you know what they say with a guy with big hands? Yeah, my dick gets lost in it.
Give it up for Tony Camacho. I'm so glad you came on. All right. And now we have our next speaker. I'm going to go wrap this up. Let's give it up for Lee Payton. Lee, come on up, Lee. Under 10 minutes, okay.
My name is Lee Payton. I used to be Geech's agent way back when. I'm sitting here watching this show, and it's going on and on and on. I think I already missed my flight tomorrow, but I'm thinking, why do they want me to talk? And now it's going to be a lot of fun going on, lots of things happening. How can we keep it going? Let's bring in his college agent from 30 years ago and let him talk for a minute. That'll keep it up. I met Geech back in the early 90s, right after Star Search. He called me to represent him in the college market, which is what I was doing those days. And at the time, Michael Paul Cathers, which is his real name, I didn't know that till the first time I had to write him a check. But right after I had signed him, I found myself totally immersed in the world of Geechy Guy. Now, most of you know and have alluded to the fact that Geech saw the world through with a childlike wonderment. And I don't mean that in a bad way, because I think it was the one characteristic that endeared him to everyone he ever met. Another thing from way back when, Geech loved amusement parks. Now, he'd come to Orlando, that's where I live, and he would stay at my house. And this was way back in the 90s, so he came and stayed, and knowing that he loved amusement parks, I said, do you want to go to Disney World? Do you want to go to SeaWorld? Do you want to go to Universal? He says, no, I want to go to the Mystery Fun House. Now, if any of you ever been to Orlando, Mystery Fun House is probably one of the oldest and cheesiest attractions there. The freestanding building, everything in there is like a carnival midway show under one roof. So it had like a crooked stairs and little things you crawled in, a mirror maze, and just all kinds of crazy things like that. We go in the door, he runs in the door. And he maneuvered every one of those little chambers, as they called him, through the eyes of a 5-year-old. It was fun to watch, but after he went through there as quick as he could, he ends up in the ball crawl. Now, picture, if you will, this 6-foot-plus, tall, lanky guy flailing around in the ball crawl, having the time of his life, grinning from ear to ear. So we're standing there trying to figure out, okay, how are we going to get him out of here? Well, he's having too much fun. Finally, the manager comes out in the afternoon, and he says, okay, you're going to have to leave. We're closing. So, very disappointed, drags Geech out of the ball crawl. We get home, and after we got back to the house, Geech realized that the watch, a gold engraved watch that Star Search had given him, was missing from his wrist. So we looked everywhere, tried to find this thing. I said, okay, it must have come off in the ball crawl. So anyway, I called the manager. He was still there. He said, well, I'm leaving for the day, but I will have the staff look for it in the morning. So we spent the evening worrying about if we'd find the watch. Sure enough, the next day at noon, I get a call from the manager. He said, we took every single ball out of that ball crawl, and yes, we found the watch. So all was right with the world at that point. So, but the one other story I wanted to tell, which is close to my heart. In 1997, my dad passed away. And Geech called me to offer his condolences. So one of the first things he asked was, what was the cause of death? And I said, well, he had a lot of medical issues that could have contributed, but I said, the only thing that the doctor mentioned was that his heart was enlarged. So we continued to talk, and I sensed that Geech was kind of going off into writer's mode there, trying to come up with the right thing to say, because he wasn't quite in the conversation. So finally we talk a little bit, and I said, Geech, I got to run. Thanks for calling. He said, I'm so sorry to hear about your dad, but he said, at least you know he had a big heart. That was a great laugh at the right moment. So, but we stayed in touch through the years, and just recently I had pitched him for a corporate gig coming up in October, and he said he'd love to do it, and it was about, I pitched it to the client. About a week later, he passed away, and my first thought when I heard that Geech had passed was, oh my God, not Geech. My second thought was, there goes that commission. I can hear him now, that joke, going, hee-hee, just like Carrot Toss. That's what he would do. Now, Geech was a good friend. He's going to be sorely missed. There's no denying he was one of a kind. No denying he was a very talented comedian with a gentle soul. There's certainly no denying that he was the one with the big heart. Thank you.
Give it up for Lee Payton. That was very touched. Are you single? I'm just kidding. Yeah, I'm just thanks for doing the one trivia. We were going to have another trivia. What's his real name? But okay, so much for that. I'm just kidding. Who cares? Right, we're almost wrapped up, and let's give it up for one of my favorite singers, Bucky Hurd.
I'm gonna be really quick. I met Geechy Guy back in 2002 in Branson, Missouri, of all places, and a comedian named Rufus, who some of you might know, brought him in. And I had a 10-piece horn band that played called the Horn Dogs. And Geech said, right away, I just met him, he goes, when you guys take a break, you mind if I get up there and do some jokes? Great, yeah, I guess so. And the band, you know, that was the time the band would go back and really pound the drinks and everything else we did. And after that time, he came in just about every week until he went on the road, and nobody went backstage anymore. And that tells you something. When a big horn band doesn't want to go backstage and drink, we want to go out front and watch Geech. He was amazing. And then coming out of COVID, I hooked up with him again here in Las Vegas, and when the Righteous Brothers were working, and Geech calls and says, and John Wiedemeyer and I were playing at Dennis Bono's place, the Bootlegger. Mind if I come out and do some jokes? And said, well, we're at 25% capacity, Geech, and there's maybe 15 people out there. And he didn't care. And we had to literally say, we got to go back on, dude. It's time to go back on. He was just that kind of guy, and he loved to make people happy. And Bill would be here, and I'm really ashamed that I didn't get a video of him, because he loves Geechy so much. And as it was noted earlier, Geech opened for Bobby and Bill. So I got a little quote from Bill, and he said, Geechy was a class act on and off the stage. As we toured together through the 80s, we got to witness all the laughs he brought to every crowd, no matter where we were. Rest in peace, Geech. And And then Tim Lee, our music director, who also toured, added this. When we got on the bus, he would travel first. He was first class traveling with the brothers. He would crawl under the bus with the luggage and say, see you in the next town. Yeah. So when I picked a song, first of all, I knew if I sang something, a ballad, I was going to, you know, break up. But I started thinking about what song to pick. And the reason I got into the music business, and I think all of us that are entertainers do what we do, is because we love to make people smile. We generally love our audience. And the love and back and forth is why we do this. And Geechy had that love for his audiences through his comedy. So I picked this song. It's called Listen to the Music by the Doobie Brothers. And if you replace music with comedy, you'll be right on point with what Geechy Guy was all about. So sit with me, this fellas.
He'll be back. He's got 6 more songs to sing. I'm just kidding. We have our next speaker. Wasn't he wonderful? Our next speaker is Howie Knave. Come on up, Howie Knave. He's a very funny, what do you do? You're a comedian, I think, right? You're a comedian. Yeah, a very funny comedian, Howie Knave. Okay.
Hello, everybody. Hi, thanks. I want to thank first Peggy and Dennis Blair.
It's Penny. Oh, you mean Peggy.
For I'm staying at their place. I never get off the mountain because I got the radio show and I just stay in Tahoe. But I'm so glad I came down here. This is a great. You guys really know how to do memorials. Shit. So I first met Geechy in the Bay Area. We were doing a show in San Jose. It was the very first time I went on stage. Geechy was middling, and Murray Langston was the headliner. It was in a dance club, and I think it was Murray because he never took the bag off, you know. And it was Geechy was great. And then the real time I got to know Geechy was when I went to Lake Tahoe. I moved to Lake Tahoe because Bud Friedman opened the improv up there and made me the permanent host and MC, and that's why I got the radio show. But then Bud brokered a deal where there was a show called The X Show. It was like a burlesque show that went on after the improv. And they wanted a comic in the middle, and Bud was like, oh, I've got just the person for you. So I knew that regular jokes weren't gonna work. They weren't there to see my tits. So Geechy was the one that bailed me out. He goes, you got to just punch them. They're not there to see a comic. And I thought it was weird they even had a comedy in a burlesque show because the girls are going to go change. And they just took it off again. And so Geechy and I sat down and he just gave me these just boom, one-liners. He said, go out with this. just do this. Do what? I go, all right. He goes, so I opened with, what's the difference between erotic and kinky? And kinky is when you use a feather. Erotic is when you use the whole chicken. And got a big laugh. And so, and then, because I can't do his grenade thing, you know, and then Geechy was a master at any show, opening for bands or in a you know, a burlesque show. And the one I really liked that I got was, what does a tofu and a vibrator have in common? They're both meat substitutes. I realized, I go, shit, you wanna come up with me? You can co-funny this thing, you know? And so he made life so much easier for me. And I think the last time I heard from Geech was, I did the Laugh Factory here at the Trop, and it was like 115 degrees. And he had messaged me saying, look, I guess he holds courts at a place on Mondays. He said, come on over, all the comics come over to this place, and we'd love to have you just hang. And I never got a chance to. It was because I wasn't booked here yet. But the last thing he did send me was, try this, because you're always on the computer all the time. He goes, Adam and Eve were the first people that violated Apple's terms and agreements. Anyway, I miss you, Geech, man. You were the best. Thanks for bailing me out, man. Thanks.
All right. Oh, sorry. Give it up. Wow, you were very funny.
Oh, Geech, we're all going to miss you. Not only did you add so much to the comedy community, but you had such a swagger, such a look. You would walk into a room and chicks would look at you and it was like time stood still. You were a fucking sight to behold. You really were. You scared children, but that's neither here nor there. I'll never forget, every time we worked together, you'd walk into the green room and all of your clothes would smell like your bottom at Burning Man. You know what I mean. Everybody there knows what I mean. You were one of a kind, buddy. So fucking funny. So inventive. Really a one of a kind. An amazing joke writer. Something that I obviously know nothing about. But as you would say, cool beans. I hope you're resting well, my friend. We go back a long, long time to the late 80s. And the last thing you said to me, and it was a while ago, I wish I'd seen you more recently, but the last thing you said to me was, Brad, go fuck yourself. And you were right. Love you.
Please give it up for Geech's former wife, Sharon Cathers.
Hello, everyone. I am the least funny person you're going to see on this stage tonight. I'm a real estate agent, but I was also Geech's wife for 25 years. Yes. And being married to him brought me a very unique and special life. And those who know him well knew what a good heart he had, what a loving person he was. And I will just tell a little story that to me illustrates what kind of person he was. The first time we met at the Improv on Melrose in LA. And we exchanged phone numbers. And he said, I'm about to go out on tour, but I'm gonna call you in 2 weeks. I'll call you at 8:00. Well, now, ladies, you know, you hear that, you don't really think too much about that. Yeah, some guy's going to call me that I just met. But something made me write that down in my date book. And sure enough, 2 weeks from that day, at 7:58, my phone was ringing. And it was Geechy Guy calling me up for that date that he had promised. And we went on that first date. And the funny thing was that I had won a trip to Hawaii on a radio contest, and I didn't have anybody to take. So there on our first date, I said, hey, for our second date, would you like to go to Hawaii? And he said, yes. Well, long story short, we spent a week there, and when we came back, we arrived at the airport, and we lived in different neighborhoods, so we left separately in cabs. And as soon as I got home, as I was walking in the door, my phone was ringing yet again, and it was Geech. And he said, I miss you. Can I come over to your place? And we were together for 25 years after that day. And I know he would so appreciate this. He loved his friends. He loved the business of comedy. And he would be so happy. I know he is so happy looking down right now at this. So thank you all very much.
Sharon Cathers. Oh, God. I wasn't going to fucking cry. I sort of am. Anyway, before we even move on, I just want to thank Mark Chinook for letting us be here at the space. Thank you, Mark Chinook. And John Katz, he's been a lot of help with us. And Jerry Jones. And thank you all so much for, okay, what are you looking for? Something. All right. We're going to do a joke bowl. Just two. That's it. All right. You ready? You ready? But the first person I'm going to call up is Joni. She went to school with him. Second grade? Joni, where are you? Joanne. Okay, sorry. Joanne. I'm not so good at that. All right. Come on, Joanne. Oh, God, this thing keeps snagging. All right. Then we're going to have another. Oh, that's not working. All right, come on up. Joanne, I'm sorry I got your name wrong. Oh, or that's a good way to come, too. That's a... All right. Here you go. There's your microphone. And then pick a joke and then tell it. Have you been drinking a little, Joanne?
We went to Rochester High School together.
That's a good story.
I can tell you more. Yeah. My nephew spent the summer at a memory camp to help him do better at school. I guess they couldn't call it concentration camp. Makes sense.
That was great. Yes.
Yeah. So I promise I wouldn't cry, but I'll get over it. That is so beautiful, that photo and everything. So even back in high school, he was a performer, and I was a junior class president. I remember we did a show to raise money for the prom and stuff, you know, and so there was another musician, Bob Hurst, who was a friend of Geechy's, and he became a famous musician, bass player, played on the Today Show with Branford Marsalis and Wynton Marsalis. Last time we saw him, she's going to put the cane on me. And we saw him play at the Charles Museum, Charles Wright Museum of African American History, where I did the John Coltrane show when he was in Detroit. Anyway, but back then in high school, we did this show, and like the kids that they were doing like weed and alcohol in the audience. And I tried to talk to the principal and let him do it again. He goes, I know they may be doing that, but I don't want to provide a place for it. But then I lost track with him, and Geechy contacted me right after my mother passed away. It was just amazing, his timing. Like, she literally just passed away. And he said, you know, I knew you were going to become a lawyer. I'm a disillusioned lawyer. I can see being a comedian is a way better thing to do. And he said, he goes, I lost my mom 19 years ago. And he goes, well, I got some bad news for you and some good news for you. He goes, the bad news is going to get worse before it gets better. He said, the good news is sometime you're going to look up. You're going to hear some music, or you're going to see something, and it's going to make you think of your mom and smile, right? But Geechy gave us so much material so that we can always laugh and smile and love him. Thank you.
Thank you, Joanne. Thank you. That was a quick story. That was okay. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring back Stephanie Calvert and Bucky Hurd for their last song, and then we have no more jokes. We'll do that later. All right, we're almost there, people.
Thanks,
No, I was going to use that one, but...
Check, check. I can use this one. Hi. Just pretend I'm Kelly Clinton. Oh,
this is perfect. This one's perfect for me.
It's just
hey,
for you.
Before we go, I want to just... I was going to tell this earlier, and I'll tell it quick. My favorite Geechy Guy joke, and Stephanie's too.
So good.
Said his wife goes into the department store, and she goes into the yoga area. She's going to buy some yoga pants. And Geechy Guy, Geechy says, well, you know, you don't do yoga. And she says, well, I'm buying them. He says, well, while you're at it, why don't you buy some do the dishes pants or some clean the house pants, maybe some sex pants, other activities you don't participate in. And so secondly, Bill would have been here, like I said, but he had a doctor's appointment, but he is out now. And if it's okay with you guys, he said I could call him and he'll want to say hello and say a little something. Is that okay with everybody?
It's an iPhone. Do you need help?
I might. Okay.
Do you have Bill's okay. Number? Oh, speakerphone.
Yeah,
Hello.
Hello, Billy. You are live here at Geechy Guy's Celebration of Life. It's been amazing, and everybody, we wish you could be here, but I told him that you had doctor's appointments. Bill says a lot of people come off the road to see their families, and he comes off the road to see his doctors. So, I'm just going to turn it over to you, my brother. So, go ahead.
Well, listen, I'm terribly sorry I couldn't be there. I love Geechy. One of the sweetest, greatest guys in the whole world. Very, very amazingly funny. He was a Righteous Brothers opening act. Every time we were in Reno, and we just always looked forward to it. And he's going to be sorely missed, and on stage and off stage. But I want to thank everybody that got there today. God bless you. Thank you. And I know Geechy would be so thrilled to death with what's going on today.
You're welcome. Thank you, my brother. We love you, ma'am. I'll talk to you in a bit. So you got to stand on this side.
Did you just hang up on Bill Medley?
I did. I just rang him up, man. No big deal. Just Bill Medley. Okay. Let me tell you something. This is a baritone song. Any of you guys know? Chris is laughing. He knows. So forgive me if I can't hit the low notes.
I think you're good.
Now I hit the time of my life, though I've never felt this way before. As I swear, it's the truth, and I owe it all to you.
'Cause I had the time of my life, and I owe it all to you.
Don't expect me to do the left. My back, I got
ready?
A bad back. Well, I've been waiting for so long. Now I finally found someone to stand by me.
He saw the writing on the wall as we felt this magical fantasy. Now with passion in our eyes, there's no way we could disguise it secretly. We seem to understand the urgency.
Just remember,
you're the one thing.
Well, I can't get enough of you.
So I'll tell you something.
Tell me something.
This could be love, because I had the time of my life. It's the truth, and I owe it all to you.
Hey, baby, it's me. I got it. Now you got it.
With my body and soul, I want you more than you'll ever know.
So we'll just let it go. Don't be afraid to lose control.
Your mind when you say
'cause you're the one thing
I can't get enough of.
Sing it, sing it. So I'll tell you something. This could be love, because I've had the time of my life. No one ever felt this way before. Yes, I swear it's the truth, and I owe it all to you, 'cause I had the time of my life. And I'm drawn through every open door till I found the truth, and I owe it all to you.
Come on.
I had the time of my life now, baby. Of my life, no one ever felt this way before.
I've never felt this way.
It's the truth, and I owe it all to you, baby.
I've had the time of my life. No one ever felt this way before.
Yes, I swear it's the truth.
Bucky Hurt. Give it up for this band.
Yeah, give it up for the band. Bucky Hurt, Stephanie Calvert. Thank you, guys. And thank we only have three more left, and we're done. But thank you, Bucky. You are amazing. Now, I'm going to call someone who, a very, very dear friend of Geechy, who wanted to be here, but he couldn't. So let's see if Bob Zaney is here. Yep, he wanted to say something.
Yeah.
Bob, you're on speaker. Oh, you're here. Well, that'll save some time. All right. Sorry, Bob. I'm sorry I hung up on you when I just forget. I'm sorry. Fuck the improv. Okay, we got to carry on. The show's almost over. All right. Give it up for Bob Zaney. I love him. Dear friend of Geechy's. And we have three more things. We're done. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for the DJ. He put the whole video together. He's going to be karaoke DJ. Give it up for our band, by the way. Fantastic. Oh, my God. Amazing. Amazing. And everyone who helped with this show, don't make me cry. Okay, please give it up for Eric Snow. Please make it quick.
Oh, hi guys, enjoying the 5-hour Geechy Memorial. I'll try and be quick. I know we had going a little bit long today, so I'll tell you a few little things about Geech, and I'll get out of here. I first met Geech at a Penny Wiggins holiday party, which is pretty much where 89% of Vegas meets their friends, and I liked him right away. He loved to sing. He was a karaoke season ticket holder. In the early days when I was filling and doing karaoke shows between my DJ gigs, he would always show up and he would just appear. You'd just look out and go, there he is, in his jacket. He'd just be right there. And Matt would come, and it was great times. Those guys were wonderful to be in the room. And then my friendship with Geech grew. You know, we'd do lunches, and Mark Wald and I, and Geech would go out and just have a blast. He was just a wonderful guy. And speaking about Geech, he had a funny little laugh. You may have seen the Carrot Top video a minute ago where he does that little hee 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 always made me fucking laugh every time he did it. And first time I heard it, I was like, what? What was that laugh? And I grew to love it. And when he made Geech laugh, he always felt like you were giving a little bit back because he was always making you laugh all the time. I love Geechy's jackets. He had his own sense of style, you know, regarding being on stage. Some of his jackets look like they came from a couch at a Willy Wonka yard sale, but they were super cool. And so was Geech. He was like the coolest nerd I ever met in my life, and I just loved him because, you know, entertainers are all nerds. It's like he had some kind of jacket wormhole in the universe he got him from. I don't know. He would never tell me. I always asked him, where you got the jacket from? He's like, hey, look over there. You know, just distract me. Anyway, I'll wrap it up because I know we're low on time here and we got to get moving. But I just want to end with this for y'all. Some people think making it entertainment means you have yourself a huge bank account, a giant mansion, or a bunch of fancy cars. In my opinion, that's not it. This is it. Having this many people who care about you and that bring so much light and support to your world, that's what's making it in this business. And looking at this crowd, you can see Geech definitely made it. And Geechy, we love you. We miss you. And we'll just keep you in our hearts forever. I love you guys all. I love all you guys. I'm never nervous. This is the first time. I love you all. Thanks for being here, you guys.
Give it up for Eric Snow. And now his roommate and the other person that put this entire show together with me, please give it up for the great and wonderful singer, Jerry Jones. Come on up, Jerry. And then we have one more and we're done. And a little video and then you can have pizza and get wasted.
Hey. Before I say a few words, and it's going to be really few, I promise, Penny, I promise. I can't just not say, hey, thanks to this band. On keyboards, that's from Little River Band, that's Chris Marion. On the drums, that's Mark Seidner. On the bass, not only a brilliant comic writer, but a great musician and a good friend, Dennis Blair. And on the guitar, the legend, Stephen Lee. That is a band, folks. Yeah. So many things I could say. Geech was my good friend. I was his landlord, oddly enough. And there's not a day that went by for all those years, almost at least 4 years that he lived with me and Amy and Tex. And he would, every day he would say, just thank you. Thank you, Jerry. Oh, this is hard. I've never been in a place like this. He thought our house was a palace compared to where he was used to being. So it was great having him there. He would come in at all hours and take a frozen Marie Callender's chicken pot pie out of the freezer and put it into the microwave in his torn-up shorts and no shirt and bare feet, like Amy referenced. And he seemed to live on nothing but pot pies. And right now, in my freezer, there's a single pot pie on a single empty shelf, and it's going to stay there. Every time he left the room, he would say, every time, okay, thank you, everybody, and just let me know if you need anything. So, Geech, let me know if you need anything. Thank you.
Give it up for Jerry Jones. Jerry Jones, stop it. I'm sorry, everybody. Matt, no, you are wasted. Get out of here. You are so wasted. Sorry, Jerry. No, stop it, Matt. Oh, my God. Are you? Just go, then. Shit. Sorry, everybody. Sorry.
This Geechy weed is really good. Settle down. I'm going to tell you Geechy's favorite joke. It was the first joke he ever told me. It was about a guy sitting at home one night and he gets a call and it's the doctor. And the guy's like, doctor, is there anything, is everything okay? And the doctor's like, fuck no, of course not. That's why I'm calling. It's about your wife. Her charts have been mixed up. She's either got syphilis or Alzheimer's, and there's no way that we can tell. And the guy is like, well, how can I tell? And the doctor says, well, that is easy. All you have to do is take her 10 miles from home and drop her off. And if she comes back, don't fuck her.
Matt Black.
I love you, Geechy Guy.
And now our last video.
Hi, everybody.
The last
Jerry
video.
McCambridge here in Las Vegas. And just the other day, we all have broken hearts. We lost our friend, Geechy Guy. Great comedian, great friend to all of us. He worked in this town. We love him so much. I wanted to send him off. We know where he's going. There's only one place for beautiful guys like that. And we want to give him a standing ovation and a thunderous applause one last time. I have an audience that I think I can do it with. Folks, tell him what you have to say.
We love you, Geechy Guy!
Hey, everybody. This is Geechy Guy. I just wanted to thank you all. Your support means the world to me. You guys are so great. Thank you again for all your support, and see you soon. Thank you very much, you guys. See you later. Bye-bye.
Some things in life are bad.
Let's give him a standing ovation.
Really might you made.
Geechy Guy.
Other things just might you swear and curse.
I love you, Geechy.
When you're chewing on life's gristle, that grumble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright
Everybody.
Side of life.
There's pizza
always
in the lobby.
Always look on the
light
side of life.
And there's chicken wings and water from the bathroom. And go out there, help yourself, and stay for karaoke. Thank you all for coming. Give yourselves a big hand.
And that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps. Just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing.
Everybody,
hey. Always look on the bright side of life.
Come on.
Always look on the bright side of life.
For life is quite absurd, and death's the final word. You must always face the curtain with a bow. Forget about your scene. Give the audience a grin. Enjoy it. It's your last chance anyhow.
So always look on the bright side of death. Just before you draw your terminal breath.
Life's a piece of shit. When you look at it, life's a laugh and death's a joke, it's true. You'll see it's all a show, keep them laughing as you go. Just remember that the last laugh is on you. And
always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the right side of life.
Come on, Brian, cue up. It's available in the foyer. Some of us got to live as well, you know. All right, it's a lot. Let's get this place up there. Change his mantle within 3 weeks. Do you think baseball is rubbish? I never made the money back, you know. I told him. I said to him, Bernie, I said, they'll never make that money back.
Thank you very much for coming along. Thank you very much for coming along. I think the voiceovers have helped the record enormously.
That's it, is it? I mean, that really is it?
Yes, thanks. That's all we need, thanks.
Oh, okay. We don't want this song, then.
No, this song is a bit de trop, I think. We have plenty of songs on the album anyway, as it happens. Is,
Who?
£30, all right? Sure to be a changing ways. I'm a cheerleader, was a real young breed. Old times like a remote.
just around the corner.